All right, hey guys, Jason here, Samco Workshop. Today we're going to talk about which is better, this one or this one. Which has the quality? How do they stand? I own both, and I've owned both for a while. They're both 2023s. We got a 4Runner TRD off-road, and we have a Rubicon Gladiator right here. So I have both of them, and yet everybody thinks these are junk, and this is king. Well, let's take a look at them. We have them here. So if we go around this thing and we look at the fit and finish factor on here, yes, it's good. It's Toyota, Japanese Toyota. I promise you this. I promise you my Tacoma was nowhere near the fit and finish of this thing, okay? But it's still not great. It's not bad, but it is not great, okay? You got all kinds of little things on here that you're going to notice on here, things like that. This thing is all plastic. This whole thing is all just plastic here everywhere. Everywhere on this thing is plastic, plastic. Plastic, wobbly, loose, kind of, you can see, look at that, okay, it's loose, again, not bad, not complaining, but a lot of plastic on everything. The lines, you know, wide gap, narrow gap, you know, everything flimsy, kind of wiggly, but again, it's still good. I'm not taking anything away from that. Plastic, plastic here, look at that here, plastic, all plastic, just, you know, just plastic's what it is. Big gap, little gap. Offset gaps, not lined up gaps, okay, you know, loose kind of thing, easy to pull. It's plastic, okay. Look at this gap in here. You know, see, you can still see the green in here. It is so hard to clean this. I have to use a brush in there because there's a gap between here, and this gets molded out being down here in a Georgia heat, and it's a nightmare to clean that kind of stuff. More plastic here, plastic here, plastic everywhere, okay. It's like I said, it's a nice truck. Don't get me wrong. I love it. Inside back here, lots of room, nice setup in here. I mean, I got no complaints on this. I'm not taking anything away from this. It is quality. It is definitely quality. And you can see we live in ours and we beat it. We got our grandson's car seat in there. That's folded down so he can see out of here. We put the back window down. It's beautiful. I am not knocking this truck at all. Okay, not taking anything away from it. Okay, but it is what, I mean, you got to understand what it is here, what we're talking about, okay? I mean, it's, you know, it's I don't know how else to put it other than it is what it is. Seats are good. Mat pockets are mesh, which is stupid because then I can see everything that you put in here, obviously, is all visible. That's just that they made them out of mesh. Why would you do that? This is, you know, it makes no sense. But again, little nitpicky kind of things in here, but the seats are very good. Everything about it is very good. I mean, like I said, I'm not knocking this truck, but when you look around it and you look at all the lines and you look at everything and it looks really good and people are like, oh, the fit and finish of quality, listen to that door, all the quality of this thing, and it's got it in spades, okay? You got a little soft touch here, a little soft touch here, hard plastics there, hard plastics here, hard plastics everywhere inside of here. Steering wheel is very nice, cushy and comfortable. I cannot complain about that. These air vents are not the best here for hanging phones on. They're kind of miserable, but good. But we don't have a compass in here. When I start this dude up and we turn this down, look how little this volume knob is, okay? That cracks me up. Look at this little radio knobs, they're so little in here, but we got nice good chunky AC knobs, which is really nice. Good solid buttons. Love the setup in here for that kind of stuff. Look how slow, come on, my gosh. But it's nice. But I do not have, I got a nice clock right here, and then probably like 6 inches or 5 inches, we got another nice clock right there. I have no compass in this vehicle. There's not a compass in here. People are like, oh, it's in here by this. It is not. Mine is a TRD non-premium. I do not have a compass in here, okay? It is the standard. I do not like leather seats, so I do not want the premium, and Toyota forces me to go with either a premium with leather or a non-premium without leather. They don't give me the option at the time I bought this. There's no option. One or the other. And I do not want leather seats. I cannot stand them. So we had to go with a non-premium. Nice setup in here. Again, ours is lived in, dirty, and you know, we, like I said, we live in it. But pretty good stuff. This gets scratched up pretty easy here. This fake carbon fiber thing, as you can see. So does this. But it's doing all right. The screen, you can't see it on here, but it's got some scratches, and I always clean it with a microfiber cloth, okay? But it's got some scratch marks in there that I try so hard, because my Tacoma was the worst. That lens scratched so easy, it was unbelievable. I never seen anything like it in any vehicle, so I was worried about that with this one. So I took my time and always was careful, and it's still got a few scratches in it that are there that you can deal with. Like I said, the touchscreen's here, but it's very, very slow to respond to anything that you do on it. Look at that. I mean, it's not real quick, but it's got some little quirks. But it's quality-wise, it is quality. It is well-built. I love that we have the actual manual shifter on here for the transfer case, which my knob, as you can see, is always spinning around and loose. Okay, so there we put it back to where it's supposed to go. But manual shift on this. I straight up love that for the transfer case. That's amazing. I would not ever... I love this feature. Love everything about this thing. Really lacking on the cup holders. We only got two in here in this little weird slot that's kind of doesn't really serve a lot of purpose to it. But it's not bad. You can't access any more cup holders in here. It's all you get are these two right here. Plus you get some in the doors also. But overall, we're talking about a very good, high-quality vehicle, okay? Everything about this thing is quality. Like I said, love these knobs, love the setup, love the solid big bumpers or big buttons right here, which are nice. Big hazard button right here on there, which is nice setup. You got your A-Track, your rear locker, your MTS, or your crawl control, your MTS, your traction control button, all easy to get to, all nice setups in here. I got no complaining on this vehicle, and I really do like this dash because it's kind of glare-free. It's not very shiny, which is a really nice feature. I do think the hump in the hood is kind of stupid because it does kind of get in your way when you're off-road to be able to see over that hump. It doesn't need to be there. Tina loves it, though. That's what matters. It's a fake hood scoop. She loves the look, and that's fine. It's her vehicle, but it doesn't really serve a whole lot of purpose to it. And like I said, off-road, it does kind of take away from your vision a little bit right there. Whether you believe it or not, or like it or don't, it does. It's just kind of, that whole thing is kind of in the way a little bit. But again, quality vehicle. I love it. I got nothing bad to say about this thing. We got analog gauges, which is really nice here. Little display in the middle, but we got analog gauges. I love that factor. This is true Toyota in its sense of off-road stuff here, where you are going to fight like mad to get it to go into 4-low. And then when you get it in 4-low, you are going to fight like mad to get it to go to engage a rear locker, to unengage a rear locker. You have to pull forward, backwards, rock it, mess with it, do all kinds of stuff. Typical Toyota fashion. That's the way they do things. Again, doesn't bother me on this too much because this is Tina's. Okay, on my Tacoma, it was the number one reason I sold that truck. But beautiful truck, quality. You know, like I said, not too bad at all. This is the gold standard as far as, you know, what we're looking for here. Japanese made. Quality vehicle, well done, well put together, and it is fantastic. Don't get me wrong, I'm not complaining too much on this thing. There's a lot of things I like. The only I do not like all of this crap and these cutouts and all this stuff that we have to deal with in this hood, because as you can see in here, it's just a nightmare to clean every little area of this through all these little pockets and crevices and into here, and all this stuff just gets to be a pain in the butt sometimes. This gap is ridiculously huge here. This one's not horrible. This one here, look how nice and tight we are here. See how tight that hood gap is? Right there, look at this one over here. It's like double the size, okay? So you got these little weird quirks in here and things like that. It's normal. It's to be expected, all right? Look at this line here. Tight and widens out. You know, you got this kind of stuff that you're going to have. It's typical, okay? But this is the top of the line. This is Japanese quality right here. This is good as it gets. This blows. These standards are like 5 times better than what American standards are, right? This is where it comes together. Well, what about this? The one that everybody says is one of the worst, okay? Where do we stand on here? Well, the fit and finish lines on this thing are 100% spot on as well, all the way through. You will not see a variation in a gap anywhere on this vehicle whatsoever. It is flawless in every sense of it. It does a fantastic job with all of that kind of stuff. Tailgates, look at perfect symmetrical gap here. Perfect symmetrical gap here. There's not even a millimeter of difference in there. Now there is some, like you can see, got a little offset here, which is to be expected. They put that little gap on here. They do the same thing on here. It's not like it's off by mistake. They did the same thing on both sides, okay? You see that little smidgen there like that, okay? Total capability, total function. Everything about this truck is comfortable, spot on, and as far as fit and finish goes, it's pretty dang flawless on every sort of level. I mean, there's not a thing that you can complain about it. There's not a rattle, not a noise, not a nothing. The seats in this thing are phenomenal. Oh, look at matte pockets on both seats, but they're actually matte pockets. They're not some matte like you get here in the doors, okay, like they have in the back of the 4Runner. So all my gear that's in these are hidden, basically, and out of the way and out of sight. The seat quality, amazing. Same, I put it right on the same par as the 4Runner. These seats, the material of these cloth seats are outstanding. I keep mine protected. I live in here, so you're going to see it's messy. I hunt for a living, and this is a vehicle that just goes nonstop. I don't ever run out of food or water to drink. This is it right here, and it is amazing. We got vents back here, just like we do in the 4Runner. We got everything we need. We got window buttons back here for them, too, as well, which is nice. We got, look at all the ports we got here. Okay, we got four USB type ports and we got an actual 120 volt right here plug right on there. How nice is that? Okay, that's a beautiful thing. Okay, to have these kind of features in here. So nice setup in here. Look at even the roof bar of this. Look at up here. Look at the quality of this thing. Okay, LED lights in there. Look at over here. Look at the setup on the speakers. I mean, we are talking pure quality on every single thing here. What about the inside? Well, let's look. Door-wise, we got a hard plastic here. We got nice soft touch right here. I like the plastic, though, because it is easier to clean. You can see I scuff and beat mine up. You can see, again, I hunt for a living, so I live out of this truck. We climb in here. Let's move this out of the way, and we look over here. Okay, it looks fired up, too, just for the heck of it. Oh, look at the size of this volume knob. Look at that compared to the one that's in there, those little baby radio knobs that we had in there. Look at the radio knobs in here. Okay, phenomenal. Okay, so very nice. So we got these in here. You can see, look at all of our buttons. Everything is right here and easy to control. Every single thing is right here, and they are hard touch buttons and they are actively fast. Everything is flawless in here, and your knobs are high quality. Okay, everything about them, spot on. They nailed it here. They absolutely crushed it. Vents, I love the vent setup that I don't just go up and down in a little twist. I can put them any place I want them to go. I can do whatever I want. That's why I use this here. It's actually my candy bar. You see it's angled down. It's my candy bar cooler. I set a Snickers bar on here, and I let that blow right down on it. It keeps my candy bars from melting. The dashboard quality. Plastic, but quality plastic, not squishy. Look, you can't push into it, you can't move it, you can't nothing. Just rock solid aluminum all across the dash here. Everything is all aluminum on this, and beautiful hard rail right here that is rock solid and doesn't move, and is soft touch all over that rail on there too. We got hard plastics here, which is good though, but they're kind of like almost rubberized a little bit. It's got a nice texture and feel to it. Nice setup down here. Like I said, I got zero complaints, even a little details. Notice how that this brake does not go straight in line. It kind of offset kicks this way. It does that on purpose. That's not a defect. I've heard people say, well, this isn't even in line. It's supposed to be over there. That way, when I can engage this brake, pull and use this brake while I'm in four low, which puts four low, puts the thing right over here. This allows you to still do that and not interfere with the knob when you're in four low on the transfer case. Okay, this transfer case knob is never turned or moved or anything, yet the one in the Forerunner is constantly vibrating and spinning itself around no matter what I do to it. Same kind of level of quality and thickness of the materials here as we have in the Forerunner, you know, that we have on these. I mean, there's you know, this is quality. Look at a level of quality on the locker buttons down here. Off-road plus, sway bar, lockers off, hard buttons. Look at the window levers right here. Even a knob right here to be able to lock that out. I mean, it's flawless, okay? I mean, listen to that. I mean, quality. Pure quality. Right here, media center right here. That's where I plug in my dash cam that I have right there set up. But everything in here is just superbly well built, well made. This is my aftermarket. This is for my pod lights that we have up here on the front. But everything in this vehicle is super tight, super good fit and finish, super quality. The steering wheel is amazing. The leather on this thing is just second to none. It's the perfect diameter of it. Everything on here is just pure quality. Analog gauges, good. Look at the size of that center digital cluster for everything we need, but we got still our analog gauges on there. We got everything we need. We got full nav. We got everything that we have to have on here is right in here. You can use your backup cam while you're actually in drive in this, which Jeep is one of the only ones that do that. But if I put this in drive and I hit my backup cam, I can still see behind me. Most vehicles, you cannot do that. I can be driving down the road and look there, and that way I can make sure everything's good with my boat that's hooked up. That boat right there, or my trailer, or anything I got on, I can actually check that while I'm going down the road. I can even zoom in on it. How nice is that? Okay, so that's a beautiful feature. Everything about this thing screams quality. And as far as the four-wheel drive system, super easy. Okay, I mean, if I had to put a number on it, if I had to compare this one and that one for four-wheel drive use, if this is a 10, then that one is a 6. Max, probably closer to 5. This one goes into four low every single time you do it. My lockers engage every single time instantly when I put them on. They are just super simple. It doesn't matter if the truck is sideways, tilted, whatever it is. Sway bar works like a champ. Everything off-road in this works exactly like it should. Where in Toyota, it's a lot of back and forth BS and headaches, and you get frustrated really quick. Especially if you're somebody like me who spends 300 miles a week buried in the swamps, and I don't want to be in Four Low all the time. I don't want to have to putz down there. I want to be able to go 35, 40 miles an hour, and then when I come up to a big old washed out hole, slow down, kick in my locker while I'm in two high even, or even if I'm in four high, but kick in my locker, roll through that obstacle and get out. I can even use my front and rear lockers in four high in this. And I'll get through that obstacle, come out, hit the disengage button, boom, turn my lockers off. They instantly go off and then I'm right on back again, woo-hoo, and fire away till I hit the next hole, 500 or half mile, 500 yards, half mile up, I gotta do it again. When you have to do that 20 times a day, dealing with the crap in a Toyota is a brutal nightmare. But I don't want to take it at 8 miles an hour or 10 miles an hour and four low the whole way. I don't have time for that. This system works flawlessly. So, and then what about this? Let's look it out here, too. Let's go this way here. So, we talked about that stuff. Now, plastic-wise, we do got plastic fenders on here, and I'm glad we do, because these, to me, are a disposable item. Okay, these are dirt cheap to buy, and as you can see, they are the thing that takes the abuse. You can see all the rock chips and dings and stuff like that in here from those tires throwing at this, but these are disposable. These are next to nothing. They're dirt cheap to buy and replace, so I'm okay with that, and I'm glad they're like that. They are not expensive, and I want them that way. Now, the only other real plastic you got on here, bumper is steel with plastic on it. It's all metal, but it's got a plastic cover on it right here. Tough as nails, and it holds up really well, goes through everything, but I don't even get marks on this. And you could see, you can't imagine the stuff I push over with this. So it works fantastic. What about this? Okay, this is what people talk about. Let me let you in on a little secret here, okay? People are like, oh, this thing, even this front end, okay, the suspension, they're like, oh, it's a Jeep, it's got, oh, death wobble and all that. You know what? This thing doesn't do anything, and I've had this is my fifth Wrangler, and not one time have I ever experienced death wobble or had any issues whatsoever. And here we have a solid front axle. You cannot get any more robust and durable than that. You cannot. This IFS stuff that's on here is great, but you cannot beat it. And look at how low all that stuff is on here, okay? Look at that. Okay, I mean, it's cool, but I mean, it sits, look at it compared to that tire. Okay, this stuff's hanging pretty low on here. Even though it's not bad, it's just, there's a lot of stuff there you gotta contend with. So the robustness and reliability, durability of this thing is off the charts. Let me open this hood for you real quick. And then, where is my, yep, we got a prop rod. You know what, I like having a prop rod. Why? Prop rods don't fail. But look at this motor. Look at this right here. Pure simplicity, a 3.6 liter V6, naturally aspirated, nothing to it, super simple. And here's the best part. How much do you think it costs to buy one of these in a crate, right from Mopar? To order this whole entire fully done motor from Mopar in a crate, if I had to put a new motor in this. What if I told you it's $6,400? $6,400 to put a brand new motor in this, and probably about $1,800 to $2,000 in labor to get it done is about what I'm guessing is you're going to be somewhere right in that neighborhood to be able to fix this, okay? Now, probably way more on that, but not bad, because it is naturally aspirated. It's not going to be like a Tundra where you're paying 30 grand for, but for $6,000, you can buy a brand new complete crate motor for this thing. That makes that pretty straight up brilliant and genius. And everything that goes wrong with this is easy to fix. And aftermarket makes every part for it. So they're beautiful. I mean, but even the components here, if you were to look them up, take a look in, because this doesn't have, you know, things that that does on there, you know, as far as front end suspension stuff. But if you were to look at repair, like put a starter in this. Okay, the starter for this, I'm going to ballpark it, but I'm going to say a starter for this is about $100, maybe $125 for a starter for this. I'll bet it's $300 for a starter for that, just to buy the part. See what I'm getting at here? There's a lot of things you got to take into consideration with them. And this one here, as far as quality, build setup, the reliability of it, the materials that are used in it, I put this right on par with that. Now, will this last longer than this will? Yes. Okay, this is a proven bulletproof design with a simple 5-speed transmission and its 4-liter V6. This is in Toyota quality and on the road and used on the road and even used light-duty off-road. This is going to run for a longer time than this Jeep is. There's no denying that. But when this thing starts to break, it costs a lot more money. It is not as capable off-road. It is Japanese quality, which is amazing. This is Jeep quality, which, as you just saw, is absolutely amazing. parts are super cheap for it, and this thing is going to do anything I need to off-road more than any other vehicle made today. This will do more of it than what that will, except for a two-door Wrangler. But this thing is super capable, and it has everything we want it to do, and it's going to last way longer than I'm going to own it for. 200,000 miles out of this thing should not be a problem, even 150. I'll never own one that long. I don't even care. I'm not going to own a vehicle past 80,000 miles. That long-term stuff, I don't care about. So it doesn't matter. This one it does, because I bought it that way, and we're going to drive this for 10 or 15 years, because we mainly use it as a second car. This one here is the one that gets all the miles put on it. This one will be swapped out in another year. It'll be gone, and I'll have either another Gladiator or a ZR2 sitting right here. But you can see that this thing here, from somebody who has both sitting right next to each other, I drive both of these every day, and yet I have no opinion in the matter. As far as like which one's better, which one's worse, I tell you, I've got tons of videos telling you how great that is. Tons of videos are telling you how great that is. That's the point. Okay? This one is not built, I could argue that this one is built worse than this one is. As far as robustness, durability, all the plastic, all the cheap stuff that's on there, like that compared to this, this is probably winning in that category. You know, this has got a compass in it. That doesn't have a compass in it. Okay, this doesn't have two clocks in stupid positions. That one does. Okay, there's a lot of little stuff like that there. Take it for what it's worth. But as far as thinking that this is a better built vehicle than this, you're kind of comparing, how would I put that? Let me think about that for a second. All right, the analogy I came up with isn't going to work because YouTube will probably demonetize it if I start talking about things like that. So we're not even going to get into that. So, but point being, both of these are absolutely amazing. Don't think for one second that this is bad, because it is not. I straight up love it. Don't think for one second that this is bad, because it's not. I straight up love it. And anybody that goes on here talking about how Jeeps are junk, they don't know their head from their rear end. They honestly don't. I don't care about their brothers, uncles, sisters, cousins, best friends, second neighbor, two houses down when they used to live in the subdivision, what their opinion was on their Jeep. I'm telling you right now, this thing here, straight up amazing when it comes to quality, fit, and finish. This is on par with this. Maybe even better. Now, some people are going to be like, well, oh, your doors are going to jam, or you're going to get corrosion around the thing. I don't have any corrosion there whatsoever yet. And that was a problem years ago. If they have it, I'm going to get it fixed. Okay. I don't care about anything that people are talking about. I'm going based on what I'm seeing. And like I said, this isn't my first rodeo with these things. Fit, finish, quality, reliability, robustness, durability of this thing is absolutely phenomenal. So is this. You cannot go wrong with either one of them. Anybody that's telling you any different, they're blowing smoke up your tailpipe. So there you go. Food for thought. Things for you to think about. Thanks for watching.